You are the true spirit of the Makoru, the shark. Not the cowardly beast that sinks its teeth into the lonely swimmer. You strike the Waikoama, the canoe, spilling a feast of men into the water. Hunters turned hunted that you dine on at your pleasure. Have this, Makoru. Claimed the most worthy of prey, Makoru. Piety, the mistress of corruption. I'm not saying the war is over, but you've given Rayclast a much-needed respite. Because of you, this land lives to see another dawn.
Piety's off to meet the Maker, is she? I'd love to be a fly on the wall of that little chat. Clarissa's guardian angel back in Horrith. Put food on the table in return for a bit of light work. I try to keep her out of trouble as best I can here. But San's full of secrets, and Clarissa's full of curiosity.
Thank you. world's greatest disappointment, heretic.
Must have time to gather my world.
Thank you. I am no beast of burden. have time to gather them.
Thank you.
destruction drives you here. But have you thought what it might drive others to do in return?
must have time to gather.
Simply stride forward into the future and expect his people to be able to follow. A leader must look over his shoulder so that he can witness and understand the consequences of the path he has chosen, to ensure that his people are still with him, to ensure that he has not become lost. Precisely where he stands.
Time to gather my will.
have here? Yet another of Oriath's cast-offs. With the problems we're facing here, I do wish they'd send someone with a little more utility. Alas, we have useless exiles blowing in like spores on the wind. Cassia, by the by. Pleasure. See this growth? Not on me, you... The fruiting body. The big mushroom. Strange, is it not? Wouldn't expect something of this scale in a place like this. Stands out like a sin during a sermon. Unfortunately, this is one of many, and they're all filled with an extremely toxic fluid. Quite dangerous to one's health. And no one is paying any attention. No one but I, of course. That's why I've attached this purification pump to the gleba. The spore mass. The big yellow round part. I plan to pump the toxic fluids from the mycelium, the rooty-looking parts, through the spore mass, robbing this growth of the fluids that allow it to thrive. Even if I can't find a use for it, at least it won't get into dangerous or clumsy hands. In response, the mycelium is going to react. Violently. This is where you enter. My mother superior used to tell us that God helps those who help each other. And I'm dubious of the sort of help you might provide, as it has not escaped me that you are, for lack of a better term, drenched in viscera. Even so, I have some devices we can deploy to help protect my purification pump here. When you're ready, start the pump, then choose a place along the mycelium to deploy a device. Then get yourself ready. As I expect, there'll be more viscera. God's warmth. Well done. Now be a good assistant and find a place to deploy a tower. Exile, are you going to build a tower as I've so kindly requested? Hello? Please do not hit.
I is playing. The blight is reacting.
The blight is trying to spread. Tasked you with protecting the pump. So ultimately, we know where the blame lies. On you, for not protecting the pump. It's in terrible shape. It may take weeks to fix it, months even. Oh no, I fixed it, thank God. Consider yourself extremely lucky. You're not ready for this yet, I suppose. I'll pray that you will be soon, as you now owe me. Get better at this, then find me. You know how to find me, right? Just go to the nearest pulsating growth. I've worked on many beautiful little machines in my time. Let's see. There was one that was originally designed to rapidly peel and pith fruit. That one is now called the Disculper. The portable oven turned out to be less of an oven and more of a red-hot ember dispenser. Still quite popular. And, of course, the towers I have been assembling for use in protecting the portable purifying pumping unit. Those I am particularly proud of. Powered by the toxic fluid that runs through the fungal fibers. Surprisingly robust and safe. Relatively safe. Almost no one has died yet who wasn't meant to.
Be alarmed. I am neither monster nor murderer, though that is the duality of existence that defines San these days. My name is Yosafuama, and I have the bleak honor of being the sole scholar to the Imperious Intellection, this grand repository of knowledge you see about you. May reason preserve us. More mundane circumstances, it would be preposterous to ask this of you, an utter stranger. But given that I don't know in which century I might see another pair of flesh and bone hands, there's a door, you see, concealed behind the shelves. It leads into the archives. That's where Issius Perandus concealed his golden pages. Can you see how maddening that would be for me? No, of course you can't. Ridiculous of me to... Suffice to say that they are beyond my reach. 4 Varlish texts they are, of priceless historical insight. Please, find my friend's golden pages and bring them to me. You will be rewarded. I vow it before the ancestors. It was a Karwi Mutiata that discarded my failing body of flesh in favor of canvas and oil. An ancient song and a momentary lapse in judgment that I've had more than enough time to regret.